Who taught you to drive like that? Out of sight. Immense freightliner from Mike Ryan. Just check out the huge spoiler and you know where he's coming from. This is hard to fault across the board, and there's not many that can match it. Lots of power. Wouldn't mind this one myself.
Famous Pikes Peak Hill Climb. The first section is the easiest bit as it's got lots of smooth tarmac and sweeping uphill bends. No need for much braking around here. We'll be right back.
get you. You're a winner.
This stage has a different vibe from the others in Canberra. It's all about speed and nerve. Some sections are quite narrow, and there are a couple of short but tight S-bends. The real fun comes at the end when you drive through the trees. But don't get caught up with the woods. Make sure you go straight to the finish.
Over crest. left 4 and right 5. 60, left 4 into right 4. And right 5 long. And left 6 and left 4 long. And crest and right 5 long. Tightens 4. And left 4 into right 4. 100. Crest, keep left. 40. Crest and crest, left 5. 60. Right 4, long. 60. Left 5, very long. Right 5. And left 5, over dip and right 5. 60. Jump. 60. Finish.
Excellent. I'm so stoked. We won!
Peugeot 307 is an old favorite because of its quick gear changes and its ability to grip out of the corners. It's all very fast, which is great, but the downside is that it doesn't like too much knocking around. If you like hugging walls in Armco, I might give this one a miss.
It's a crossover stage with a purpose-built permanent racetrack. It's not as technical as Spain, but it's just as challenging. You can use the curves to keep your speed up, but don't overdo it, otherwise you'll spin out in the wider turns. At the end of the lap in the outside lane, the final left-hander under the bridge is tighter than the previous turn, so watch out.
Tires. Tiger.